Hello, good morning, or good evening, whenever you are watching this. I hope you are doing well. My name is Catherine, and today I have some springtime recommendations for you. So spring is fast approaching. In fact, it is only a week away, which is crazy. This year has been insane. Spring is one of my favorite seasons for a lot of reasons. It is the start of Aries season, which is the best season. My birthday is, you know, coming up. Flowers are starting to bloom, but there are still those like spring rainy days that happen, which I always love a nice spring rainy day. But if you live in SoCal like me, you can still go to the beach. When I think of like springtime reads, I think of books that like have a message of like hope and darkness, you know, flowers blooming after a long winter, that sort of thing. I also feel like romances are just particularly nice to read during springtime. So I have just a couple recommendations to start out the spring season. First is The Sun Is Also a Star by Nicola Yoon. This follows Natasha and Daniel. Natasha is about to be deported back to Jamaica, her and her family. They've lived in America her entire life, basically, but because they aren't technically citizens, they end up having to get deported. And then Daniel has an interview with like a college like board member to go to school, I believe, to go to medical school, but all he really wants is to be a poet. The two of them meet one fateful day, and Daniel is convinced that Natasha is a soulmate. Natasha is very like practical and is like, no, there's no such thing as soulmates, but she can't deny her attraction to Daniel. I absolutely love this book. It is just so beautifully written. It follows the two perspectives of Natasha and Daniel, but it also has different perspectives thrown in there of people that they come across, people who they meet just randomly, and how those like little meetings can affect someone's entire day, entire life. It's so incredible. And I just absolutely love the writing style in this book. Next is Foolish Hearts by Emma Mills. This follows Claudia after she gets roped into being in a production of Midsummer Night's Dream at her school. Now I know Midsummer Night's Dream is technically like a summer type book because it's the start of summer, is midsummer. But something about it just feels very spring to me because, I mean, the fairies and in the forest, I guess. I don't know. This book is such a just sweet contemporary. It has like high school romance. It has theater, which I always love a book that involves theater. Overall, if you're just looking for something light and fluffy and sweet to read, definitely recommend. On the same vein of like fairies and magical worlds, I also recommend The Kingdom of Bach by Marie Lu. This book is about Mozart's sister. It is a fictionalized tale following a very real person. Nannerl has always like lived in her brother's shadow because she is a girl and her gifts with music are never going to be as like recognized as her brother. Her and her brother, as they like travel and tour through the different countries, create this story of a kingdom called Bach. However, the Kingdom of Bach might be a very real place. It's a very whimsical story. It does have some like darker elements to it for sure, but I really love the fact that it brings to light the story of this very real woman whose accomplishments were just completely diminished because she was a woman. The writing style in this story is just so beautiful and so magical. And again, highly recommend. Next is On the Other Side by Carrie Hope Fletcher. This book is about Evie Snow. It starts out and she has actually passed away and is going to go enter the door to heaven or the next life or wherever the afterlife leads you. But when she goes to walk through that door, she finds that she is her 27-year-old self again. Basically, her soul is too heavy and burdened down with secrets for her to pass on through the afterlife. It does sound kind of dark, but like, it's a really beautiful book about like living a satisfying life and living the life that you want to live. It's a very beautiful magical realism book and I just absolutely love it. Also love Carrie Hope Fletcher. What a star. Next, I recommend Lovely War. This was one of my favorite books that I read in 2020. I absolutely fell in love with this story. It has dual timelines. Our first timeline follows Aphrodite, who's been having an affair with the god Ares. She ends up getting caught by her husband Hephaestus and she has to basically plead her case so that she is not like made a fool in front of the other gods. In order to do that, she tells the story of one of her favorite couples that she basically cause to fall in love. And that is our second timeline, which takes place during World War I. This book, I feel like, is the definition of finding light in dark places. I absolutely love the dual timelines and the way that this story is written. To me, it feels very theatrical, and I just absolutely loved it. Last but not least, who would I be if I didn't recommend The Hobbit? What? Catherine recommending The Hobbit? Who'd have thought? No, but if you are looking for a fantasy, I feel like hobbits are the definition of like springtime creatures. They love anything green that grows. The Shire. I would love to be in the Shire in spring and summer and winter and fall. I just love to be in the Shire. If you don't know what The Hobbit is, it is about Bilbo Baggins, who is a hobbit. Now, hobbits never do anything unexpected. They never go on any adventures. But when the wizard Gandalf comes calling, he ends up going on this mission with 13 dwarves to go reclaim their kingdom under the Lonely Mountain, which years ago was taken over by the dragon Smaug. It is such a fun adventure book, and what I love about it is you have Bilbo, who no one really expected anything of him, and he went on this incredible journey through the book and came out as a very different person. Anyone who is a bit wary about maybe reading the Lord of the Rings series, I definitely recommend starting this one. It is such a great introduction to the world, and it really is written like a children's story. So it's very easy to read through. It's not super complicated. I'll be real, like it's a simple book. It's a simple, beautiful, lovely book. So there you go. Those are some books that I recommend starting off your springtime season. If you have any book recommendations for me that give you those springtime vibes, please leave them down below. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this, be sure to hit subscribe. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, and until next time, bye!